Hi, I'm Tracy Randolph with Coldwell Banker, and I'm here with my client and friend Adam. He was a client of mine a year and a half ago. We did a new build together and in the Norterra area. And so we are going to talk today about why it's good to have an agent represent you when you're walking in for the first time to a new build. So Adam, can you tell me what it was that, you know, really made it important to you to have somebody represent you when you were doing a new build?
I think that when you walk in, it's very overwhelming. There's a lot of moving parts. So you get in there and there's so many different stages, and it's kind of hard to juggle it all and to make sure you're not kind of getting taken advantage of. You know, sometimes you might feel like the builder is trying to do what's best for them. When you have somebody on the outside looking in, it really helps you understand the process and helps you get the best, you know, maybe the best deal, or at least feel like you're being taken care of. So it's good to have. So that was very helpful for me. And there's a lot of times in the process where there's problems, and sometimes you might not want to deal with the builder directly. So having, you know, someone like you call,
right,
it's a lot easier to have that. And you know that happened multiple times with us. So,
right.
and we came out of it happy with what we got and happy with the finishes and happy with the process. Even the process was a little tough, but
right,
you know, in the end it was good.
Right. And so, and especially like even when we went to the design center together, you know, that was something that was important for me to be there.
Right.
Especially, you know, can be overwhelming. And so helping you pick out different finishes for the home, because sometimes, you know, you can't visualize everything, and it's very daunting to have, you know, them tell you one thing about the price of something, and then you walk in and everything adds up very quickly, right? So, you know, that was something that was nice to be able to be there for them for that. And then tell them about what happened with, like, the tile in the house. What did we experience?
So, all right. So, first of all, I'm going to almost back up a little bit. The design center is kind of was probably the most painful experience throughout the whole thing, because yeah, things stack up very quickly. It's like 10,000 turns into 75,000 turns into whatever. But I feel like maybe sometimes the designer doesn't seem like they care so much. They want to get it done a little bit. I mean, they're kind of helpful, but for me, I think it was more helpful to have you there to kind of start asking the questions and start helping us figure stuff out, because it gets really overwhelming. And you know, you want, once you're done with the house, you want to make sure, if you're building a brand new home, you want to have everything that you want, right? You don't want to skip on things, and you want to be happy when you walk in. But that was very helpful for me. But with the tile, first of all, the grout was the wrong color. So, and that was what the designer suggested we use. And we walked in there, and it just didn't look great. But also, when they installed it, the grout was way too thick.
Right.
So, you know, it almost doubled the size that it should have been.
Right. So what they had chosen is the wood tiles, which is really popular now. And so the idea is that for it to look like a wood floor, but, you know, when you have that along with a wide grout line, it takes away from the purpose of having the wood tiles. So, you know, we were able to accomplish getting them to rip out the tiles, and the whole entire flooring of the entire house had been done, and we were able to negotiate with the builder to redo the flooring. So you guys were happy.
Yes, so we were happy with that, and they actually didn't even charge us. I think that as a buyer, you know, you might be a little ignorant when it comes to things you can and can't do, and you know, you walk into that and you're not happy, you might just say like, you know what, well, I don't want to spend more money. You might not try to do anything with it. You know, having somebody with the expertise that can tell you like, no, we can give them a call and see what they can do for you, it kind of just makes it easier and makes it a smoother process. So
yeah.
They took care of it. It looks great. No complaints. So that was amazing.
Yeah, and then we did the walkthrough process with the project manager, and and they were pretty much on point with getting things taken care of. After that point, they knew we meant business.
Yeah, they knew we were, because I don't think a builder goes out of their way necessarily to do something extra if they don't have to. That's their time and money. So sometimes you have to be, you know, make the initiation, you have to be a little bit maybe more aggressive, or, you know, you need to have someone in your corner helping you through that. Whereas if you just kind of scoot along, you're not going to get what you want, most likely, or you might not be happy with the process. So.
Right. So that's my goal. My goal is to be there, you know, to help people through the process, make sure it's smooth and fun, because it should be a really fun process, you know, when you're really creating something from the ground up. You know, you want to make sure that, you know, everybody is enjoying it and, you know, it's not stressful. And so I'm happy to help in that process. So thank you so much, Adam. You're awesome. I really am grateful for you being here. And so, yeah.